all the meds are neatly in one basket. I like it because I can see. Here's where we are today. Tomorrow is Tuesday the 13th, which will be cycle day 3. And I'm going in for my blood work. And then I just did a slash at the bottom. So next Sunday is the 18th. I'll redo it as we go through. But right now what we have on the calendar is the 13th, tomorrow for blood work. That's kind of that, and then I'll walk you to the room. I want to show you what I did in the closet. So I had the stuff in like different spots. I mentioned that yesterday. Like, thanks for clicking on Simply Tanika. I am Tanika. If you are new here, welcome. Hit that subscribe button. Let's hang out a while. If you are returning, welcome. What's up, fertility fam? We gotta do what? Let's get those babies, ladies. I see the crystal raindrops fall and the beauty. Good morning, fertility fam. How are you? Today is Monday, November 12th. It is the observance of Veterans Day. Again, thank you to all who have served. There was a parade here yesterday in New York. I didn't go to it, but my neighbor went, and he is a veteran. I think I mentioned that. He said it was really nice. I hope you all celebrated our heroes in whatever way made sense for you here in the US. I am headed into the office. I'm going at a slow trot. You may have noticed I am not running late. I am okay. I probably will get there with 20 minutes to spare. Today is just a day of relaxation. I did not get up and work out this morning. I slept in. I will do some yoga tonight. I had that already planned, the Kundalini yoga at home for about 40 minutes. I'm gonna make myself a nice meal. It's actually spaghetti with the zucchini noodles that I saw from Tamika TTC. And yes, I bought them, I did not make them. And then I got some Italian spicy sausage and some sweet sausage, like ground up. I'm gonna make meatballs with that. And some crushed tomatoes that I will make a sauce with, and basil that I definitely need to get going on. So that's what I'm gonna do for myself tonight. Have a little date night with myself and just relax. Tomorrow is the cycle day 3 blood work. So I have it mapped out what I'm meant to do every day, because Team Too Much does that. Relaxing is the day of the order, preparing my vessel for my child. And yeah, I'm kind of excited about that actually. Doing a lot of nothing, or a lot of just being good to myself. I will not be doing my intermittent fasting until after, I don't know until when, but right now I won't be doing it. I think the most important thing to focus on is the follicles. And so I'm working on that and the follicle growth. So right now we're shedding lining. It's cycle day 2. Cycle day 3 we'll continue to shed lining, but the body then starts to rebuild the lining. And I just want to make sure all nutrients are on deck when needed. Not to say that with the intermittent fasting you don't get all your nutrients. I just think it's timed out, and so I don't want to risk it. I don't want to be the $15,000 guinea pig on that. So I'm not going to do it, but I will try to eat as keto-esque as possible to keep my body in the ketogenic state. I still have a few pounds to lose. I would like to lose at least 4 by the time we have egg retrieval, which I don't even know now if I can do that, because logistically it's next week. It's about 10 days away, right? So we'll see. We'll see. I will put forth the effort and I'm not gonna stress myself about it. Gonna be cool as a cucumber. So yeah, I'm excited to relax. I'm actually excited to relax. I've marked it on my calendar, which is a funny thing to do, but I think all the things that are important to us, you know, manage to get on our schedule, and relaxing should get on there as well. So I have calendared that in. Time for me. Me and the vessel. All right, ladies, I hope that you are planning to do something nice for yourself. Let me know down below. Do you do anything? Do you put it on your calendar when you want to relax, like a bubble bath or read a book or just cook a good meal, like a warm, yummy, healthy meal? Let me know how you manage your self-care and how you date yourself, you know? Because that's what I'm doing tonight. I'm having a date with myself. I hope you do too. Talk to you in a bit. Bye. All right.
have made it to work and things are hopping along. The doctor's office called and confirmed they sent the Novorel over to the correct pharmacy now. And then I went to GNC and got some stuff like... I got some ashwagandha, which I believe I did a video about the benefits of ashwagandha. And if I did, I'll link it over here. And then I also got some Castile soap, the organic soap. I got that soap for retrieval because you can't wear any fragrance and I have molten brown at home for soap, and so I'm worried about that.
Got it.
Hi, thank you. So yeah, that's what's going on over here. I'm gonna take the ashwagandha, and I got the clinical strength. I don't know, it's 600 milligrams, so yeah. Hey fam, all right, I'm home. I wanted to show you really quickly the basket. So I showed you the basket that I got last night while we were at Target, and it's now in the fridge. And so here you can see, I think, there. All the meds are neatly in one basket. I like it because I can see through the basket. I can see through there. And it's nice and square at the bottom. The Tupperware container was rounded, and so things could not fit up against it. So that is there. And yeah, all good to go. And then I'll show you where the other stuff is. Okay, and here is over in the desk space. I think you guys have seen this area before, but I added the calendar, the weekly calendar that I got. It's all filled out. Here's where we are today. Tomorrow is Tuesday the 13th, which will be cycle day 3. And I'm going in for my blood work. And then I just did a slash at the bottom. So next Sunday is the 18th. I'll redo it as we go through. But right now what we have on the calendar is the 13th, tomorrow, for blood work. And then I go back on Friday, the 16th, which is cycle day 6, for blood work. And then I go in on Sunday at 9 o'clock, which is the 18th, for blood work. Yeah. So that's kind of that, and then I'll walk you to the room. I want to show you what I did in the closet. So I had the stuff in like different spots. I mentioned that yesterday. Like I had some stuff up here. Here is where the needle box was, and here's where like those alcohol swabs, and then I had the band-aids in here, and then I had stuff that's in the bedroom. So in the closet. So here are all the meds in there. There's the bag, that's the pouch that I'm gonna put. This is what I'm gonna take to work when I take the progesterone. So I'll have to put one of these in there and the progesterone tablets in that bag, so I'll take it to work. Here is the sharp container, the alcohol swabs, I have the band-aids in here, and then I have all the Minipure in here, and the Q-caps, doxycycline is down there. There we go. So, oops. Doxycycline and progesterone are down there, so it's all nice and neat in one container, and then that's just sitting in the closet. It's kind of hard to do with one hand. But yeah, so that's just on the shelf in the closet over there. So yeah. Oh, and I almost forgot. The little teething rings that I have are nice and frozen. So I will use those to numb where I'm going to put my shots. So that was the last bit of organizing I felt like I had to do in order to feel like not chaotic in the house and have it organized for the shot. So yeah, that's it. I'm gonna put this on sticks and then I'll sit down and kind of do a quick recap of what is going on with the diet and scheduling and all things IVF. Be right back.
Hey PM, how are you? So I got my pomegranate juice going. It's half palm, half seltzer. I put my collagen in here, which is a white powder that now looks purple. We're just gonna drink it. We're not gonna overthink it. Okay, so I just wanted to recap. I showed you guys a little bit of this earlier. I got the Castile soap. This is 18-in-1 hemp lavender pure Castile soap. I'm using this, or I'm planning, I'm gonna start using it now so I can get used to it, but on retrieval day, you can't have any scents. Perfume lotion, so I'm gonna wash with that instead of my Molten Brown because Molten Brown has added fragrance. Yeah, I've got to get an outfit for retrieval day, which I was debating if I was gonna get like a cute sassy t-shirt, but it's one day and I only want to do it once, and so I think I'm just gonna like get something comfortable. I have like this nice turtleneck and a cashmere sweater that I get throw over, and it's like drapey and it's like a cashmere like poncho sweater, and I think with some leggings maybe, we'll see, but that's my next thing. I figure out my retrieval outfit. Anyway, I got that. I got the ashwagandha. I showed you guys this earlier, but here it is. I want to recap where we are. So I still have on my estrogen patch. I've been doing what is called estrogen priming protocol, EPP. If you haven't seen my estrogen priming informational video, I'll post it over here. But basically, I've taken this since 6DPO, 6 days post-ovulation. I still have on the patch. You guys heard the nurse. She said leave it on until it falls off, so it hasn't fallen off. I probably will just take it off in the shower tomorrow. So I've had it on for about 8-9 days now, and I just wanted to refresh. I do have the other video, but I'll just recap here. If you want more details, please refer to the other video on what the estrogen priming does. So I pulled it up. Estrogen is used in the EPP to down regulate the follicle stimulating hormone. So you'll remember before my FSH, follicle stimulating hormone, has been running high. The last time, I think it was like at 22, the last two cycles that they told me it was, that they measured it, it was at 22. So that's too high for a successful IVF or for me to be successfully stimulated. They like it below 20, ideally below 10. I think if it's over 20, they won't move forward. Over 15, they predict a poor response, and then 10 is ideal. So they're giving me the estrogen to calm down my follicle stimulating hormone so that it's not spiked, which we're getting that tested tomorrow on cycle day 3. So by providing external estrogen, the hope is that the pituitary gland will think a follicle is developing. Follicles produce estrogen. We know that because later we go in and we get our estradiol reading, right? So they look at your E2 to see the correlation between how many follicles they see and what your E2 is, or your estrogen or estradiol. And they like it to, they average it to be about 1 to 200 per follicle. So we'll just say 150 for an average. So if I have 2 follicles growing, they would look for at least 300 estradiol to confirm that there are 2 mature eggs in those follicles. So by suppressing that, it will reduce the amount of FSH that my body is pumping out, and so therefore I won't have a high FSH when I go in, and I will respond better to the stimulating meds when we get into that part of the cycle. This break in follicular development gives the ovaries a little time off, so they're kind of at the spa, chilling. They don't have any extra work going on. They think that they're already working on the creation of follicles, so nothing extra is happening. They just get to relax. In addition, this promotes estrogen dominance in the follicular fluid, which is believed will help protect the developing eggs. So that all kind of makes sense, right? This protocol is normally recommended for people who are, for women who are low or poor responders and have a high FSH and or are over the age of 35. It's a slow burn methodology, the hope being that they slow you way down and protect egg quality while allowing you to stim longer. In addition, the slower stimming allows the hope that all active follicles can catch up to each other, allowing for as many mature eggs at retrieval as possible. So that's what Nurse Christina was referring to when she said on the phone, when I asked her in that one call, here, I'll link it here, where they confirmed that I was moving forward with my cycle, was that
they want the eggs or the follicles to kind of grow at the same rate, right? We don't want to have two that are way out ahead and five that are way behind, because those two ahead are taking the lead and you have to follow those, because once they're ready to go, there she blows, they're ready to go. So we won't have time to catch up those other ones. So the idea is to kind of control them so they're all coming up at the same time. So that's what has been going on as far as the estrogen priming. And then I also did the Sertraline, which in this case is also meant to control the egg growth so that they're going at the same time, at the same rate, keeping them kind of in lockstep with each other. So that's the idea. That was the reason why they said no unprotected sex during the prior cycle, because if I fell pregnant and it didn't register on a test, on a blood test on cycle day or on 6DPO, the Sertraline can cause abortion, and so, or cause harm to a fetus. It's counterindicated for pregnancy. And I know some of you ask, well, why wouldn't they just do a pregnancy test? They did do a pregnancy test. It was 6DPO. We're all pionistic addicts. We know that at that point, it doesn't necessarily mean that it will come back accurate. So I could have gotten a false negative, or even, and not just pionistic, but also in a blood test. It's too soon to tell. We often go in when we're doing art and have a 6 or 7 DPO reading, or a cycle day 21 reading of our progesterone. They also do HCG at that time. It's just too soon to tell. And so to be on the safe side, they recommend no unprotected sex. Now, technically, after you confirm ovulation, you should be able to have unprotected sex between then and the start of the new cycle, because there is no risk of pregnancy. And then after the new cycle starts, obviously you would not want to have sperm introduced into the vagina. So that's kind of what that is. Here are the patches that I've been taking. I've had them on, like I said, it's been about 8 days. It's 0.1 milligram a day, and you put it on one side and then you wear it there. So if I put it on a Friday, like Friday 9 p.m., I would take it off. And then on Sunday, I would take it off on Sunday at 9 p.m. on the one side. So if I had it on the right side, take that one off and then put a new one on the left side at 9 p.m. on Sunday. And then 2 days later, do the same thing. So I have on my last patch that I think went on Sunday morning. I think it either Sunday morning or Saturday morning. I don't know. But anyway, when I take the shower, like I said, tomorrow, I will take it off and then that will be that. Hopefully my FSH is low and I'm going to respond well. I did the Sertraline for 3 days. So I did the Sertraline 7DPO, 8DPO, 9DPO, and then that was it. Again, that's to help the follicles kind of grow at the same rate. So that is kind of that as far as what we just finished. Estrogen patch comes off tomorrow. Go in for FSH in the morning and a scan. So we'll see kind of what my antral follicle count is, my resting follicle count. So they'll do a preliminary scan. They'll look at everything. They won't measure the size of the follicles. They just want to see, like, do I have 4 on the right, 2 on the left? How thick is my lining? And that is our baseline, meaning where we started. We'll see what it is tomorrow morning. And then I'll go in the morning. They will call me back with the results, the blood test results, so my E2 and my FSH, in the afternoon. I think if I get in, the earlier I get in, the earlier they'll call me. I have a meeting from 4 to 5, so I wanna get in early so that they don't call me during that meeting, because I wanna talk to Katrina. And then that's it. I got the note that my Novorel was called in to the new pharmacy, but when I called the new pharmacy, they didn't have it yet. I will call again tomorrow. Not a big deal. I just wanna get it checked off of the list, so that'll be like the last of all my meds. And then yeah, the only thing I have to figure out is what I'm going to wear. I think that's it. So, what I'm gonna wear for egg retrieval. I'm claiming it now. I think I said this last week, like, I feel this is it. I feel this baby is going to happen. And so I'm just gonna speak it into existence. I'm not gonna say if, hope. The goal is baby, and it's gonna happen. It's gonna happen. I feel that, which is crazy, because today is what, the 12th? And so by the 12th of December, I'll be pregnant, like in less than 30 days, which is awesome. That is the plan. Oh, I don't know if I mentioned, so my sister had mentioned she's not coming out, and then I got a text message from my mom today that she's not coming out, and so I'm gonna be alone. Well, Cheyenne will be here, but Cheyenne will have a new job that she's starting tomorrow, so I'll be home. I've taken those 2 weeks off. That's it, ladies. That is it. Cycle day 2. I'm gonna make some meatballs. I mentioned that this morning, and do a little bit of yoga and then head off to bed. I'm gonna try to get to the clinic instead of going at 8 tomorrow. I think I'm gonna try 7:30. It's going down. It's going down. Yeah, so I finished up my old lady EPP estrogen priming protocol. And hopefully that is the magic trick. I hope you are well. let me know how things are going. Oh, two ladies, I didn't ask them. Two ladies got BFPs, and I don't want to say their names, but I do want to say congratulations. If you contact me with a BFP, let me know if it's okay for me to say at least your screen name. Some people, I know you don't want to share it yet, and you're just sharing with me, and I'm excited that you share with me. I love to hear about BFPs. So I'll just say that to the fam. Keep them in your prayers. There are two family members who just got their BFPs. We want them to be sticky babies. We want them to have their take-home babies. And so let's keep them in our prayers. And let's keep everybody, all the other ladies who are still in the game, who are going to conceive and working on it, let's keep them in our prayers as well. Thank you, ladies. I will talk to you later. Bye. Baby dust to us all. To make those rainbows in my mind when I think of you sometime, and I want to spend some